Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a very important concept, a very important topic, that is earning per share formula. This is really very important from all the stakeholders' point of view, from the investors' point of view. Any investor who is investing, he'll first see what is the EPS, net income. I know that's important, but EPS is a very vital issue which every investor considers before investing. And earning per share, what does it denote? Is how much the net income each share has earned during the year. That is what we are determining. So if the EPS is 1, then it's the same. If it's 2, then 2 times, that means it denotes that how much net income each share has earned. So accordingly, you can make some analysis, but don't worry, we are going to go with the flow so that we understand how exactly this formula works. Now, in the simple terms, EPS, that is the earning per share formula, it denotes how much the net income each share that is earned during the year. Now, the formula goes for EPS something like this. EPS is equal to your net income, if any, less any preferred dividend in the due course, that is the preferred dividend, divide by the weighted average number of, or I'll just write for you, weighted average number of shares outstanding. So this is basically your formula, right, for EPS. Now, let's understand the explanation part of this formula. In EPS formula, there are two parts. The first, that is the numerator. This is your first part. Now, in the numerator, we are deducting what? The preference dividend, right? This is the preference dividend that we are deducting from the net income. We are deducting the preference dividend from the net income because this ratio is only a measure of, wait for it, common shares. Right. Now, second, which is your denominator. In the denominator, we'll take the weighted average of common outstanding shares. Right. And then divide the difference between the net income and the preference dividend. So, in the denominator also, we'll only include what? The common shares and not the shareholders' equity. And that's why there would be no PSE, that is the preference share capital. No preference share capital over here too. So this won't be there. Now, earning per share formula, and I'm talking about the EPS and the return on equity, that is the ROE, are almost similar ratio. The only difference lies in the denominator. In this case, in the case of the return on equity, we take shareholders' equity in the denominator. But in case of EPS, we only take the average outstanding common shares. This is the major difference between the EPS and the ROE. Right. Now, what exactly is the use of this particular formula? See, every investor invests into a company stock mainly for two reasons. The first, the investor invests in a company stock because they expect a handsome amount of dividend, you can say, from the company. Secondly, if the investor may see a great growth potential of the company in the near future, and if the company grows, or the growth, the share price will also rise, that is, our P0 will also take a rise. And that will only help the investor in ensuring a great return on their investments. So for this two reasons, investors use the ratio earning per share formula. So using this ratio will help them to understand whether a company has a great growth, whether the company has shown a great amount of a growth potential, and also how much dividend a company may pay to its shareholder in the near future. So a higher EPS, basically you can say, usually tells us the investor that the company has been growing. The company has been, you can say, growing, and the financial health of the company is great. And a lower EPS will suggest, on the other hand, you know, the lower EPS may create a doubt in the minds of the investors about the company. So let's say the net income is actually decreasing. So in many countries, the public companies need to show forth their EPS in the income statement. They have to show in the income statement of their financial statement. So usually the companies record EPS after the net income in the income statement. Let's take the example of the earning per share formula so that we have some idea. Let's say there's a company called HIT Technology, or HIT Tech is the name of the company. It has some details, something like this: the net income, which is 4,50,000, right? They have the preferred dividend, the PD, which is $30,000 at the preferred dividend for 2017. We are talking over here, preference dividend for 2017, and the net income for 2017. Now, at the beginning of the year of 2017, the common shares outstanding was 50,000. In the middle of the year, okay, it issued another 40,000 common shares. Now what we need to do, we need to find the EPS over here of HIT Technology. So in the example, we know that the net income over here and the preferred dividend, that means we know all the information that is supposed to be needed in the numerator. However, we don't know the weighted average over here of the common shares outstanding, because we need to calculate that from the data given. So let's calculate the weighted average number of the common shares outstanding as the first thing. Weighted average common shares outstanding. It is said that at the beginning of the year, the firm had how much? 50,000 common shares. And in the middle, 40,000 new common shares were issued. It means that we can consider 50,000 shares for the entire year. So this is for the whole year. And 40,000 is for the 6 months. And this is for the whole year. That is what the conclusion that comes out. Here, the calculation of weighted average number of common shares is going to be is equal to 50,000, that was the outstanding for the whole year, 1 into 1, plus 40,000 shares, that was outstanding for only for half, that is the 6 months. So we'll consider as 0.5, that is 6 months divided by 12 months, right? Close the bracket, we get 70,000 shares as the total weighted average shares, or common shares. So now we can apply the EPS formula, something like this, is equal to our net income, that is 4,50,000, less the preference dividend, which is your 30,000, divide by the weighted average shares outstanding. So our final EPS should conclude as 6 per share. My goodness, that's a really good thing. Earning per share is a really important component in any business, as I told you. Now, EPS is divided into two parts. One is called the basic EPS and another is called the diluted EPS. Now basic, this what we did, what we calculated over here is the basic EPS. The diluted EPS is one big chapter, is a one big thing, because it involves the securities like options, convertible debentures, convertible bonds. You can say this all components are basically dilutive in nature. Dilutive means the basic EPS, the diluted EPS is going to be less. So if the basic is greater than the dilutive, that means the dilutive EPS is perfect. But if the basic is, when it is less than the diluted EPS, then in that scenario, that it is not dilutive, it is called the anti-dilutive component or the anti-dilutive EPS. So this is what you will get to understand in another topic.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.